All right, I hope this recording is actually working. Was a bit strange here. All right, so couple of 3 minutes game coming up, and let's see what happens here. I'm playing an international master here from Britain, from the UK, and have some rate here opening here, trying to open up the position quickly. Okay. Now I like to keep my pawn structure intact here. Sorry, knight takes e4 wasn't without its pawns either. Wondering about e5 here. Yeah, maybe this freeing the bishop immediately and eyeing b7 pawn could be a good idea. Only need to be cautious here because of my development, which isn't so great. He might have something on f2 at some point. Okay, so from a structure point of view, this is nice. Also two bishops. But move like knight g4 here is a bit irritating. Yeah, so how do I protect this actually? Rook f1. Yeah, I might need to. Rook d2, also possible, but not sure if it makes a huge difference. Yeah, okay, maybe he can try to. If we play h3 now, can he do some sacrifice? Not sure. But I don't think so. I think he needs to retreat now. So what now? How do I get my pieces out here? He's got knight d3 also as an idea, which is also not nice. Not nice at all. Okay, maybe I should try to exchange something here. Also protecting the d3 square so that I maybe just take it. Okay, but I don't need to take right away, right?
Time warning.
Yeah, it's really not nice. I can play this kind of move first and see what he's doing. Yeah, I have absolutely no possibilities here to play active moves. Okay, I need to get rid of this piece. Doesn't help. And now I'm trying to get on the c file. Yeah, position is okay. I'm very much down on time due to the difficulties earlier, but I'm certainly not worse here. Trying to get rid of
Check.
one rook here. Maybe I should have taken. No.
Check.
Yeah, there's not much going on here, really, besides the fact that I'm low on time. Trying to catch up a bit on the clock here. Not caring so much about the position.
Check.
Hard to believe that he can do all this with his king.
Check.
But maybe this is really the case.
Check. 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 Check.
I can take on h6 now.
Black forfeits on time.
Yeah, well, what can you do? A typical time scramble. Not so sure what this position is. I mean, am I losing? Probably. I mean, it's equal material, but his f-pawn is very dangerous. This might be lost. Yeah, now I can just take e3, but it was just time scramble, just moving.
Check.
And check. I blundered this piece and won on time at the end with 2 versus 2 seconds or something. Yeah, well, it's 3 minute chess. What can you do? All right, next game. I lost so many on time before.
Game started.
Okay. Queen's Gambit. Or the Albans. Okay. Yeah, there are many good lines against this opening. I often play this e3 line. Always wondering what's Black's point is here, really. Besides weakening himself and so on. Yeah, well, this is just... yeah, and he plays it all immediately. Okay, so how to refute this? Okay, let's win some tempi first. Yeah, well, the problem with 3 minutes. 3 minutes is always... tricky time wise. Oh, here queen e7 might be really an idea.
Check.
Okay, I need to get a square for the king or d1. Yeah, he takes f3 maybe wasn't the best. I mean, still, I like my position. Black is all, I mean, this is all in disarray here. King on d1 also isn't brilliant, but still, what now, b5? I guess it's long. Oh, cool. Yeah, so, okay, let's try to open it up, b5. On knight e5, I just play rook e1. He might take on d3 then. Okay. Yeah, he might take on d3. All right. So
check.
Okay, let's use this tempo. Now queen a7 checkmate threatened. Rook e1, another tempo gain. Really? Okay. Now let's take this tempo also. So yeah, okay. This looks like mean, shouldn't I be totally winning here? Everything else would be hugely unfair, really. I don't see a win. Bishop d7 he can take. Bishop e4, I can play knight g7. But should be okay anyway. I can play bishop f1. And now he's got no square to retreat to. Just this. Okay, so bishop f4 was my plan. So g3, yeah.
Time warning.
g3, planning bishop f4. I think he needs to play a move like g5 now to actually prevent this. Yeah, okay, so what now? Taking and rook e6 or something? He might have a check. Okay, so this is the other idea, getting rid of this knights. Maybe this is the most direct way to do it. Really somewhat weird position. But okay, knight takes e6. It's really a winning threat here. And what should you do? Don't see a move really. Okay.
Check.
Yeah, but rook e8, yeah. I've got so if he takes with a knight, rook e8. It's also curtains. No move. Queen a7 mate. What? Knight c8. Knight c8. Rook.
Black
yeah.
Resigns.
Yeah, knight c8, rook e8. Also over. Alright, yeah, this was just too insane. I mean, the Albans is really, really a bit of risky. I mean, it's not entirely incorrect or something, but really risky.
Game started.
Okay, so some international master here from Italy. Okay, let's go for King's Indian setup and see what he's doing. Okay, he's going for some English opening. Okay, I'll try to exchange this strong bishop on g2 with bishop h3. Okay, let's get rid of this piece. It's really a bit annoying. So what is he doing? c5 or b6? Okay. Okay, I need to keep this this closed here. Maybe I can go for the very simple, let's play simple chess here. Attacking h2. Now I just need to dislodge this knight on f3 and he's gone. Knight h4. He would need to take with the pawn. I take with the queen. It's not so stupid. But maybe I should try to prepare this a bit more. Or simply h5. Come on, h5, h4 is also not bad at all. Should I play e4 here? It's a bit risky, maybe. I cannot yet sacrifice, so I think, anywhere. Ah, he might. He might have knight g5. The silly move, yeah. Mm-hmm. Ah, this is stupid. I didn't really think about knight g5. Yeah, the problem is it's a whole rook, yeah. It's not not just an exchange. Okay, so might need to go back here. It's not what I wanted to do. Obviously. Really stupid. Yeah, this looks shaky. Another queen b2 and stuff like this.
Check. Time warning.
Need to adjust the audio. It's terribly loud. Yeah, I'm not sure if he really has got some knockout now. Move like knight f6 now. It's not bad, but I'm not sure that it wins outright. Okay, just attacks the queen. Okay, I don't want to exchange queens yet. Maybe I can get e4. At least e3 is hanging now. Oops. Yeah, it's not playing that bad at all. At least quite decisive play from white. Okay, guess I need to cover here a8. But it's maybe not entirely clear, I'm not sure. Those knights are not doing so much at the moment. Knight e5 to g4. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but this is a pin also. This is...
Check.
Time. The time. Okay, so I'm glad to get to this. Okay, so what's happening here? I'm two pawns up.
Check. Check.
But down on time.
Check. 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 Check.
Rook h3 mate. Ah, shame. Yeah, all pre-move now. Okay, let's do a draw here.
Check, game, draw.
Maybe I could have tried on time even at the end. He was so slow. Yeah, I should have won this. But of course I was in huge trouble before. So maybe okay result. Okay, next game. No, I'm not getting a game. Weird. 3 minute games usually you get really quickly. And now nothing's happening at all. I pressed this button, right? Yeah.
Game
okay,
started.
Here's the next game. Okay, let's go e4 here. And play, oops. 92 would have been bad. Okay, so we transpose into a Sicilian here. Let's see what line is playing. Okay, the Taimanov-Paulsen line. I'm just developing normally here. H5. Yeah, he wants to go knight g4, yeah. Not sure. This position h5 is really really irritates me. I think with the bishop on d3, this is a known line. I'm not sure about this really. Whoa, b5. What about e5 now? What do you play then? Maybe sacking this pawn, knight g4, or yeah, he needs to go knight g4, really. Everything else just looks, back to g8 cannot be the idea. Knight d5, I just take, and black is in terrible shape with this pawn structure. Yeah, he needs to go knight g4 now, for better or worse. I mean, okay, this is cool. I didn't see that, really. Okay, he didn't plan it also, but okay, I need to grab the knight. Cannot, whenever I move the knight, then he plays knight d5 himself. So okay, recapture, yeah, I guess so. So quite a sharp position here. So should I take h5? It's not so much the pawn. I'd like to put pressure on f7. Okay, I'll grab this. Yeah, bishop b7, I guess. I was actually thinking about stuff like f5, e5, knight e6, stuff like this, this idea, but okay, h2, is this an issue? Well, this is cool. I mean, he's got nothing developed and just moves around with his knight. Okay, so how can I actually punish this? Knight c4, maybe queen here. If he goes knight c4, I go rook a to e1. So what happens if I take it on f5?
Time warning.
Okay, I mean, just if black can play all this, yeah, maybe he can, but hard to believe all this. Okay, so what kind of lines are there? F7 is hanging. I'm also threatening queen e4, picking up the rook, and a5 is just stranded also. No idea. I mean, also, if he gives me just one move here, I play. Okay, so what now? Bishop f7, king, queen takes, queen e5, something like this, but it's maybe not entirely winning. Okay, check. But I need to move here.
Check.
Okay, you can pick up e3, sure, check. But now I've got rook e1 coming. He's all tied down with his pieces. He's got three pieces for rook, yeah, which should be winning, but I mean, I really hope this attack wins now. everything else I would consider hugely, hugely unfair, really. But okay, maybe I didn't play the best also, very likely.
Check.
Okay, but this looks winning now. Rook e8, check.
Check.
Yeah, bishop.
Check.
And this is mate next
check,
move.
Checkmate.
Yeah, hard to tell in a 3 minute game. It all was super provocative what he played there. Well, the computer actually gives this as completely winning. I had the right hunch there. Okay, computer wants to take on f7 now. Yeah, well, this looks really, really, really good, yeah. Yeah, this is completely winning. This may be... Yeah.
Check. Check. Check.
Computer says it's equal. Funny. Yeah, okay. Well, it doesn't so matter so much what the computer calculates here. In a 3 minute game, this is close to impossible to defend. All right, let's request the next game here. And it really takes a while to get a game. Really not used to this. Normally you just get them one after the other.
Game started.
All right, there we go. Let's play e4 again. Another Sicilian. Yeah, the dragon is always... Always a surprise how popular this opening really is still. I mean, black is losing so much with this. But, well, people seem to like it. Okay, I played some positional line, not the Yugoslav attack with the long castles, but more of a strategical line, which doesn't look too threatening for black, but it has some points. I mean, g5 and h5, well, hard to believe. Okay, so I'll complete my development here. I want to play knight d5, of course, and now I can do it. This is just a nice piece, and it's hard for him to tolerate this knight. But if he takes, I'll capture with the pawn and then get the e-file open. Okay. I don't mind to exchange this bishop, obviously. His g7 bishop is a good defending piece. So right now g5, maybe just g5. Wow, okay. Knight d4, f5, something like this. It doesn't look too bad. I could think of f's. Yeah, he really is playing this cool. He could think about this. I was trying to say, and grabbing h4. I mean, knight e6 and so on. So looks really, really a bit much. But okay, he's attacking b2 also. Yeah, I'll just cover this. Play it simple. Yeah, okay, you can have this pawn. So how to continue here? I'd like to get rid of one knight here. This bishop on f1 is not doing so much. I could play bishop f5 also, or maybe this one, winning a tempo. And maybe even queen h6 here, queen h6 to h5. Also threatening queen h7 now, and everything's hanging basically. How does he protect it now? King f8, I play knight e6 check and win the house. Bishop e6 also wasn't bad, but I don't see a move here at all on this move. Yeah, no move, I think. He just loses lots of material now. At least a piece. Yeah, no move. Yeah, I'm not sure, but this whole thing here with advancing on the king side and grabbing all those pawns and such, I cannot believe resigned. This. Really can't believe this, that you can play this. Alright, so next game. Maybe I'll get a quicker game. So what's the score for this session here? Let's check quickly. Not too bad, actually. 5 games and I just conceded 1 draw, okay. So I won a couple of points. I've got 4 white games in a row. Funny. I mean, not in a row, but 4 white games out of five total. Surprising. And still some waiting time here between games.
Game started.
Okay, a black game. Okay, let's check the king's idiot. Okay, what is he doing? Yeah, style of the world championship match. Transpose into a same-ish. Yeah, there are all kinds of lines here that black can play. I'm trying to play something less common here. This is aiming for quick play on the queen side, combining queen side and central play. So a bit out of fashion, this kind of setup, but it's not really bad. I mean, also not great, but it's playable. Okay, so trying to open up the position here. Interesting. Isn't this nice now? Don't know. Yeah, okay, he's got e4. He's got e4 protected. And I've got a very weird bishop on b7. Yeah, maybe this is quite good for white. Could be. Yeah, knight c5. I was more afraid of knight c5. Okay, but it's not like that I would have here. Great move. Okay. I want to activate pieces here. Give up the exchange, but I want to cover this c5 and d6 squares. It's I don't know, otherwise I'm so passive. didn't like it. Maybe I can get something going on the king here. It's certainly not the kind of 100% correct sacrifice, but maybe I can get some play here. Not sure, don't see a direct refutation, and he's taking some time. Okay, so maybe c5 now, c5 with activating the bishop. Okay, at least I'm threatening something. Bishop takes f3. Okay. Now I could actually enter here, right? Oh, and now this bishop. Yeah, I'm getting something going here.
Check.
Let's open it up here. Queen e4, knight f2. Okay. Winning quite some material here for the queen.
Check.
Not quite sure if this is working. Okay, I can stupid, you can just counter sacrifice and I'm down material just in exchange. Yeah, I mean, okay, I could actually resign here. But maybe he makes some technical mistakes here. This actually isn't 100% easy. What's now? No move or some disconnection here. I mean, this is technically not so easy even.
White forfeits on time.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe some connection issue or something. Yeah, okay. I mean, okay, white should win here, but it's technically not easy at all in such time, at least. Maybe white should attack f7 and then try to run with the king all the way to e8. Difficult. Okay, so request a new game. Last one for the session to get some 40-45 minute video. Yeah, it looked promising. I mean, this kind of position really I really liked. Computer gives white close to winning advantage all the time, yeah, you see. Now it wants to take on f3 and play knight f2, cool, yeah, c4 was not working, I mean, it was apparently
game
pretty quickly.
Started.
Okay, there's a new game here, and maybe this is sort of a match point for getting the 2200, maybe. Okay, so we transpose into French defense here, the McCutcheon variation, and he's playing very quickly. I don't know the opening. Just experimenting here. So, okay, he's attacking e4, so what does black play here? Okay, maybe I can first attack the queen. Okay, and now strike in the center.
Check.
Yeah, now I'm threatening queen c3. This looks a bit ugly. Okay. So if I take now, it's got bishop d2. Okay, I need to clarify this here. And now threaten knight d4 again. Yeah. Yeah, my dark squares are obviously very weak. Queen f6 in particular is quite dangerous. Okay, losing e4 is not so terrible. Okay, maybe I need to cover those, and now trying to play bishop to c6. He can grab a pawn, but okay. Yeah, he's playing very quickly, which has its benefits, obviously, but once in a while, thinking might help. Now a threatening mate on g2, and the bishop is hanging, so how does he save his bishop now? Yeah, I think he had a pretty promising and it's a pretty promising position, but yeah, you need to invest time once in a while, at least a couple of seconds, to avoid blundering pieces and such. I think I just win this now. Yeah, now he lets the clock run down, doesn't seem to find a move. Yeah, this for instance, he played in 4 seconds. I mean, why? You can think of all kinds of moves, queen b7, rook to whatever, d1, b1. And this also played almost instantly. I mean, after bishop c6, you really need to recognize that this long diagonal is quite dangerous. And okay, this immediately wins a piece. And now he lets the clock run down. Brilliant. But I'll get the point in 10 seconds.
White forfeits on time.
Yeah, actually made it to 2201 here in this session. And let's check quickly. Yeah, I really only conceded one draw here, but very sketchy play. I mean, also winning on time and stuff. All right, so thanks for watching. I hope you liked it. It was more entertainment than educational, maybe. But thanks for watching anyway, and talk to you soon with new stuff.